Hey everyone, it's Daphne from Scrap and Create. I hope everybody's doing well. It's been a while. It's just life keeps getting in the way. Lots of things to do, family, friends, and we're coming on holiday. So we're working on what is going to be an 8.5 by 8.5 by 2.5 inch mini album. It's going to have four pocket pages in it. Those pocket pages, the finished pocket page will be 8 by 8. So I start with 2 8.5 by 8, score a 1/2 inch on the 8.5 inch side, and then join them to create a pocket. Right now we're going to work on the cover. So I've got some things ready, and we're going to do the cover and the inside liner. So these come from the 12 by 12 background pack, and they're going to go on the bottom. And this also comes from the 12 by 12 background top, and it's gonna go on the top like so. So I'm gonna set these other pieces for the cover aside for the moment. And we're gonna go ahead and double check our measurements and make sure we are out of the hinge area. And that looks a little too tight, so I think I might scoot it over a little. Yeah, it looks like it's right in there, so I'm just gonna take a little bit more off to make sure I'm completely clear of the hinge. I did use the white bookbinding tape. If you are doing it in white, the bookbinding tape will work. If you're doing it in black, the paper from, I can't remember her name, Claire Chevelle, but I can't remember her channel name. That black construction tape is awesome. I use it right here when I'm doing a black book now. It's so much easier to work with than the bookbinding tape. I like the look of the bookbinding tape, but it's super sticky and not very forgiving. Okay, there we go. So again, this is from the backgrounds, and I gotta hop up real quick because I can't remember if I hit record, which happens once in a while. There we go. And it looks like I did. Yay! Okay, so now we're gonna do double check dry fit. This one looks like it's gonna be okay. Oh, I forgot to tell you, this is Sweet Winter. I told you it's backgrounds, but I forgot to tell you it's Sweet Winter by Stamperia. Oh my. I hope everybody's doing well. I just released yesterday another reveal from Stamperia, so there is another collection that we just received. Perfume, and it's very pretty. I think you should take a look at that, see what you think. Okay, that's gonna need to be trimmed down a little. So I'm just gonna make it exactly the same width as the panel below it. There we go. I'm gonna check this one. That's my little sticky. I cut it so long ago, I knew if I didn't label it, I'd forget which pack it came out of. Okay, we're ready to go. So I am just overlapping this slightly on the panel that's here. I'm not gonna color block because there's no white paper here. And I didn't, well, you can put some white paper there if you want. But I just didn't do it. So I'm just gonna overlap a little bit. Same thing here. I think this pattern is so sweet and pretty. And it also looks great with the green dots or speckles. It's not really dots. Okay, now as usual, all of the white paper cardstock cut information, cut score information is in the description. So if you go to the description and click on Show More, you will find all of the cut information. Okay, so you can't really see it, but there's the backside. This is the pattern that also came from the background pack that I'm using so that I can use the 8x8 as my cover piece, since it's not gonna go all the way out to 8.5. So you can either have a large white border or you can do what I did and create what's gonna be two borders, okay? So this came from the 8x8 collection pack. I used diamond glaze, which is a dimensional glaze that dries clear and shiny. And then I added some gold Winkostella on top, and then I did some gold Winkostella splashes. And then I also added Winkostella to some strategic locations on the print, like in the stamen area of the flowers, okay? So that's the cover. And I'm gonna lay it on top. It definitely goes on one way better than the other. Let's see. And that looks about right. So then all the way around the edge, you'll see that it looks a little bit like antique silver gold. That's also Winkostella. So I just took the edge of the brush and ran it around to create that shimmer. I'm gonna double check, dry fit one more time before I commit to glue. See that I've got it. It looks like it fits the best this way. It's just one layer of chipboard. And these are just scraps left over. Okay, I'm gonna let that dry and set it aside and put some weight on it. And then, so this is the cover. Here's our back. This is what I chose for the back, and it is also, from the 12x12 background. And I wanted to keep it simple, and it's gonna wrap around the side and give this a nice finished look. Oh, I didn't really dry fit it. I just went a little too quick. Actually, it needs to be trimmed just a little bit. This does have an orientation, so pay attention to what is up and down with the words in the background. Okay, it looks like it's good. So I'm gonna go ahead and add my glue and we'll put this down. If you're not familiar with the bookbinding tape or how to apply it, under tips, tools, and techniques, there's a video that shows how I install the bookbinding tape, because it is super sticky, and I'm demonstrating it in black, but it's essentially the same thing, just a different color. Like I said, I really like it. It has this texture that makes it feel like fabric. It's just hard to work with. It's very easy to lay it down in the wrong spot or have it adhere to itself and you cannot take it apart. If it behaves a lot like duct tape. Okay, I think this is drying up. So we're gonna lay this down. We're gonna make sure it's going in the right direction, and it is. That's the wrong glue bottle. That's my refill. I switched to the smaller tip and I used less glue, but I'm not used to it. It's gonna take a little while. Couple more projects. Doesn't that look pretty? And it has dimension, even though I haven't added anything yet. Okay, now somewhere I have a strip for the spine and it matches the back of this. So let me find that. I thought I did. I'm not finding it right away, but I'm pretty sure I've already trimmed it out, so I don't want to cut through anything else. This was from the 12 by 12, and so whatever I cut off, I saved for that. So it's just a matter of locating it. And here it is. Okay, and I'm also keeping this super simple. I am going to put some elements on the spine. I'm going to be using the clear chipboard. I don't know what they call it. I'm sorry, that's my head. I'm going to be using two packs, die cuts, and then the other is the clear. Let me show you an example. These clear, they're like plastic. I'm going to be using those throughout the album as well. So I'm definitely going to put something on the side here. And all of that information is available in the description. If you click on the show more, the first thing I show you is the material list with links to the shop, followed by the cut list. That's too high. Too far over. There we go. I'm not happy with that either. I'm gonna start over with some more glue. Oh, goodness. It's hard to see the edges when the book wants to open. Starting to panic that I had the words upside down, but they're not. Okay, so that's the cover for now. And you can see where I've got these splashes. And basically, what I did was I unscrewed this tip and then just squeezed a couple of drops around. And you get that effect. And just to be clear, it doesn't say. It says E21999, and I think it is what's considered clear. It just has a lot of shimmer. It does look quite gold, though, and I think it looks good. Okay, I am going to add a couple of elements here and here, but for right now, I'm going to stop, get those things organized before we come back and finish this video.
Wow. My goodness. Okay. Oh my goodness. Ha ha.